हेलो
हेलो। सो इन द डीएनए रेप्लिकेशन, व्हेन एवर डीएनए इज रेप्लिकेटिंग, द टू स्ट्रैंड्स विच आर कॉइल्ड टुगेदर, दे अनवाइंड, दे विल सेपरेट एंड बिकम्स टेम्पलेट। सो टू स्ट्रैंड्स, टू टेम्पलेट्स, बेस्ड ऑन दीज टेम्पलेट्स न्यू स्ट्रैंड्स आर गोइंग टू सिंथेसाइज दिस। So always in a new DNA molecule, one strand is from the old DNA and one strand is new DNA. Like this, one DNA molecule separated and becomes two DNA molecules, which are called daughter DNA molecules. These two daughter DNA molecules, they consist of one old strand, one new strand, one old strand, one new strand. So this method is called semi-conservative, not completely conservative. Out of the two, in one, only one strand is present, another one, another strand is present. So DNA molecule having bonds like this, it will separate. So bonds will be separated. Based upon this, so this is new strand is going to synthesize completely like this, like this. And finally, one DNA molecule finally becomes two DNA molecules. Here, both are same and both are similar to their parent. It is because of base complementarity, complementary base pairing, which governs. So this is two daughter DNA molecules, new DNA molecules, one from the old, one new, one from the old, one new. This is called semi-conservative method. So in this semi-conservative method of replication, which was experimentally proved by Meselson and Stahl, in E. coli bacteria, Escherichia coli bacteria, later Taylor et al. In Vicia faba beans, these experiments and concluded DNA is showing replication semi-conservatively. Then here, what they have used? They have used heavy isotope of N15. And N15 heavy isotope incorporated into DNA. E. coli bacteria. How they have incorporated? They used a medium, this NH4Cl, to this nitrogen N15 isotope. So this N15, E. coli cells are growing here, So E. coli cells will absorb, will take this nitrogen. So in the body of E. coli, they will E. coli cells undergoes replication in 18 minutes. After that, cell division or binary fission, reproduction, 20 minutes once. So E. coli bacteria replication timing, replication time 18 minutes it will take, and after 2 minutes, 20 minutes, within 20 minutes E. coli bacteria is going to divide. 1 becomes 2, 2 becomes 4, 4 becomes 8, 8 becomes 16, 16 becomes at the rate of 2 power. So now after 20 minutes, when they have taken the Escherichia coli bacterial cells and centrifuged, in that centrifuge apparatus, these, in the beginning, heavy isotope is having N15 at the bottom of the test tube. After 20 minutes, here a mixed hybrid DNA with N14 and N15. Why, sir? Because they have taken and they have collected N15 in the bacterial cells. Then they will send this in normal medium we have taken in the previous class. So bacterial cells which are grown in heavy isotopes, they absorb N15. So a bacteria having both the strands N15, 15 kept in a medium of N14 normal, it undergoes replication by taking this. I'm showing the same here. Both the strands are N15 heavy. Now, when they were kept in N14 medium, normal medium, from the medium they will take nitrogen, that is N14. So they were showing after every 20 minutes, 18 to 20 minutes replication, and here after 20 minutes, this DNA is separated here, N15, 15 separated from the medium, N14, which is called normal, is developed. From the medium, normal. So N14, N15, N14, N15. These two are called hybrid DNA molecules. So hybrid DNA molecules, it is in the bottom, it is in the center. After 20 minutes more, one more 20 minutes, that is, if we take from the beginning, 40 minutes, 20 minutes, next 20 minutes, that is 20 plus 20, 40 minutes. And we'll send this for ultra centrifugation. Again, these will separate, these two DNA strands will separate and becomes template. These two DNA strands separate and become template. From the N14, they will get N14. What is this? N15, already it is having N14. And from the medium, what is this medium? N14 medium. In the N14, it will take again N14. Here, N14 already. Template, N15 template. Now from the medium, they will get N14. Medium N14. So after 20 minutes, from the starting, first 20 minutes, one DNA becomes two DNA molecules. Two DNA molecules become four DNA molecules after 40 minutes. In these four molecules of DNA, how many are having N14, how many are having N15 or N14 hybrids? When we test here hybrid DNA and both the strands are normal DNA. So normal. So out of the four 25, if we count out of the 100, 50% normal are light DNA molecules, not having heavy isotope, and 50% hybrid DNA molecule. In that, 14 and 15 both are present. 50%. This result, then only we will get when DNA is showing semi-conservative way. If it is not showing semi-conservative way, we are not going to get this type of results. And my dear students, here this is heavy, which is present at the bottom. When we observe this in the centrifuge apparatus, here light DNA N14, here hybrid DNA N14, here heavy DNA in the beginning. So no DNA molecule in this is having complete heavy, only mixture. If we continue this for some more generations, that is third generation for 60 minutes or fourth generation for 80 minutes, the result goes on. What will be there? All will form. If it becomes two, all will form N14 only the last one will form N15. Only the last one forms N15. So hybrid DNA, normal or light DNA. Or normal DNA, 50% hybrid DNA, in a hybrid DNA, N14 and 15 both are present. 25 25 25 25 25 plus 25 50. This is, now we are going to see concept oriented questions in this aspect of semi conservative method of replication. Concept oriented. For example, they will ask a question like this. A person hybrid DNA. You have to practice, my dear students. When we take hybrid DNA, it means two strands. One strand is heavy N15, another strand is normal N14. Such a DNA is called hybrid DNA. When we take hybrid DNA and keep in N14 normal medium, so medium is normal N14, what happens after two generations? after three generation, they will ask and options, maybe ratios or percentage or number of strands, how many strands are having light, how many strands are, what is how many strands here, how many strands are having light, 1 2 3 4 5 6. So out of 8 strands, 6 strands are having light, 2 strands are having heavy. 6 light, 2 heavy strands, polynucleotide chains. Now again, whenever we take a hybrid molecule, N14 and N15 kept in N14 medium, after 20 minutes, what will be the amount of percentage of light, heavy, normal? So here these two will separate. Heavy will be like this, N15. Light will be like this, N14. So what is there in the medium? N14 is there in the medium. It will take, synthesize new strand, N14. New strand, N14. I have shown the colors to show you. Otherwise, both are same, N14. So here, how many hybrids are there? What is the percentage of hybrid and normal and heavy? There is no percentage of heavy. Hybrid 50%, normal 50%. First 20 minutes. Second 20 minutes, that is 40 minutes. Second, after second reproduction or cell division or replication, what is the percentage? Again, it will separate heavy, light. From here, normal, heavy, light. From the normal, both will get again normal. These two separate, normal, old normal. Again, from the medium N14, they will synthesize new strands. Here N14 14 14. So how many DNA molecules are having, complete light? 1 2 3. 3 DNA molecules completely. So 25% hybrid, 75% light. How many strands out of 8? How many strands? N14, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 strands. Only one strand, N15. 7 strands, N14. What is the percentage? Options. How much amount of heavy, light, hybrid? 3 questions generally they used to ask. Here, there is no heavy at all. So heavy is 0. Heavy DNA molecules, both the DNA strands should be heavy. So heavy DNA molecules, 0. Light DNA molecules, 1 2 3 3 DNA 1 2 3 DNA molecule hybrid DNA molecule 1. So my dear students, only based on the concept they will change medium or they will change DNA, initial DNA, parental DNA. If they take both are N15, if they take both are N14 and medium is N15, or if they take hybrid, if we change this N15, for example, if we change a hybrid DNA kept in N15 medium, N15 means heavy, medium having heavy isotopes of heavy medium. So what happens? N14 first, we kept it here. After 20 minutes, this N15, N14, from the medium N15 they will take. So from the medium they will take N15. What will be the percentage? Again changes. Both the strands heavy, so heavy DNA molecule. After hybrid DNA molecule, after 40 minutes, that is 2 becomes 4. What happens? Let us take N15 from the medium, N15 and N15 from the medium. Here N15, N14, here from the medium N15, from the medium N15. So total amount of heavy 1 2 3, heavy is 3 DNA molecule, lighter, there is no light DNA, so heavy 3 DNA molecules, light 0, hybrid 1, hybrid 1. So the ratio after the second generation, that is after third generation, again you will get 8 DNA molecules, here only 4. In 8 DNA molecules, 8 into 2, 16 strands. What is the percentage? What is the ratio? So my dear students, possibility of asking various dimensions of questions based on DNA semi-conservative method of replication. By changing this, half an hour it will take, 20 to half, 20 minutes or half an hour. Take white paper or rough notes or exercise book. Create your own, how many types of DNAs possibility. You can give both light, both heavy or hybrid, three possibilities. Both light, N14 and N14, one experiment. Second experiment, both heavy, N15, N15, second experiment. Third experiment, N14, N15. And here possibilities, two mediums. What are those two mediums? Either N15 medium or N14 medium. So how many possible? Two generations, first generation, second generation. Third generation, 60 minutes. In the NCERT book, they asked after 80 minutes, what will be the? In the NCERT book, they have asked at the end of this replication topic, last sentences, how many will be there after 80 minutes? So easily we can predict. Unless we do some work, we are not going to get any result here. So remember this, three types of changes, normal, heavy, hybrid. Now the process of DNA replication DNA replication process or mechanism of DNA replication. So in simplest way, DNA replication means a DNA molecule having two strands. It will separate these two strands. Based upon the separated two strands, new strands are synthesized. To listen is very simple, but it is not simple. It is a complex and complicated process. The involvement of so many enzymes, involvement of energy, involvement of substrates. So a process beautifully defined by Watson and Crick. Going to show replication. Here, and finally, when it is separating, these two old strands are act as templates. Based on these templates, new strands are synthesized. And finally, two DNA molecules. Two DNA molecules. So one DNA becomes two daughter DNA, both are identical to each other and they were similar to their parent. This is because of the rule of base complementarity, complementary base pairing. In the beginning itself they have given, if we know the sequence of N2 bases in one strand, we can predict the sequence of N2 bases on the other strands. When we know the two strands are separated, automatically based on complementary base pairing, new strands can be synthesized. This process, and it requires stepwise enzymes, several enzymes. Substrates. Energy. What are substrates? The nucleotides, which are deoxyadenosine monophosphate, deoxythymidine monophosphate, which are present in the DNA. Why a nucleotide is made up of deoxyribose sugar, N2 base, phosphoric acid, phosphate group. Phosphate, deoxyribose sugar, N2 base, 3 is equal to. So in the N2 base, maybe adenine, guanine, thymine or cytosine. Deoxyribose sugar, pentose sugar, and phosphoric acid in the form of phosphate. So here one phosphate is always monophosphate. Now here, before entering into the process, we will see the requirements. These are the requirements which are required. What are the enzymes, or what are the chemical substances that are responsible for replication? Let us see this. Enzymes. helicase enzyme. Single stranded B stands for binding, P stands for proteins. Topoisomerase in bacteria or prokaryotes, it is called gyrase. RNA primase. RNA primer. The most important DNA polymerase, which is called the chief enzyme, chief supervisor, chief everything, which is also called, it was developed from the DNA and to produce DNA. From the DNA to produce new DNA molecule. So it is called DNA dependent, DNA polymerase. Polymerase means the reaction which is going to increase the number of polynucleotides. Polymerase reactions means formation of nucleotides. DNA polymerase or DNA dependent DNA polymerase coming from the DNA and for producing the DNA. It is various types. DNA dependent DNA polymerase types. DNA dependent DNA polymerase 1. DNA dependent DNA polymerase. DNA polymerase 2. DNA polymerase. DNA polymerase 2, DNA polymerase 3. So each and every enzymes are having their own specific importance and function during the process of replication. And this is being the chief enzyme. And I have given here order of enzymes which are going to work in the process of synthesis of new DNA molecule from the old DNA. Helicase enzymes, single stranded binding proteins, topoisomerases, which are called gyrases. What are these? RNA primase, RNA primer, and above all, DNA polymerase. How this synthesis of new DNA molecule occurs? Let us see. Stepwise process to understand DNA replication. So, to understand, DNA is such a long molecule having 2.2 meters length or 6.6 into 10 to the power of 9 base pairs. 6.6 into 10 to the power of 9 base pairs having length of DNA molecule. is all of a sudden if it has to separate and form means it is requires more energy and complicated. That's why this DNA molecule, which is this much in length, in the form of short segments, it will replicate, and the replication process will start at a particular place. Replication process starts at a particular place. That particular place is called origin of replication, or it is called ori site. Origin of replication or ori site. You can write like this: RDNA polymerase 1, DNA polymerase 2, DNA polymerase 3. Out of these, most important is DNA polymerase 3, which is responsible for replication process. The other two helps in the process of replication. We'll see what is the work of these. So in the total DNA molecule of this much of length, 2.2 meters of DNA molecule length, it is in the form of small fractions. For example, this is DNA molecule. At a particular place in this, here. So in eukaryotic organisms, like plants, animals, human beings, all eukaryotic organisms, origin of replication means the place, the site where it starts the process of replication is called origin of replication, or simply ORI site, RE site. And in eukaryotes, because of this much of length of DNA, here ORI site is there, here some ORI site, here some. So at various places in this long molecule of DNA, so many hundreds of ORI sites are there, which will help to maintain, the energy sources and disturbance in the DNA replication. So the enzymes which are responsible for these are so much accurate and active and efficient. What is meant by efficient, accurate, active? They will start synthesizing of nucleotides at a faster rate, 2000 base pairs. 2000 base pairs time per second, per minute. So in Escherichia coli bacteria, that is prokaryotic organism, in prokaryotes, for replication, it will take 18 minutes, complete replication. In prokaryote means bacteria, Escherichia coli, within 18 minutes at the rate of 2000 base pairs per second, how much they are going to, and this much fast, and when they were going to fast accurately, for example, if DNA is separated, adenine, thymine, guanine is here, when it is going to synthesize that much faster rate, guanine, cytosine, thymine, guanine, it means wrong base pair. It should not be wrong. Even though it is fast, it is so accurate, the process of replication is so accurate, correct base pairs, there is no mismatching. If any mismatching occurs, these enzymes, polymerase 1, polymerase 2, they are responsible to remove those. So a process of DNA repair. In the previous classes, we have seen DNA is more stable because it is having a mechanism of DNA repair and it is having two strands. So in the coming classes, we are going to watch. Even though it is fast and accurate, but accurate, if any mistake happens, it leads to mutations. If any mistake happens in the process of replication, which leads to any mistake, any mismatch, leads to mutation. Mutation means a sudden change. So without any mutation, fastly and accurately, the process is going on smoothly. So here, origin of replication, let us see these terms. In this total eukaryotic, this much of length of DNA in eukaryotes, there are several places where origin of replication or starting point of replication or initiation of replication or site is located. Whereas in prokaryotes, in bacteria, the DNA is circular. In this, only at one place, RE site is present. RE, origin of replication. In eukaryotes, so many places, RE. And whenever a particular RE site is there, the replication process is bidirectional. It will move in this direction and in this direction. How to understand here? In prokaryotes, RE means this is DNA molecule. For example, LR, complementary base pairing. For example, this is RE site where it will break the bonds. When it breaks the bonds, these two strands will bulge like a loop. See the diagram. So here it is. United only. Here it is broken down. So it will go like this and like this. That is called bidirectional. So whenever it is moving, new strand will be synthesized on the old strand here. New strand will be synthesized on the old strand. Like that, the loop goes on, and here new DNA molecule, here new DNA molecule will be formed in prokaryotes. A single RE site. So what is this RE site? RE site means the place in the DNA molecule where DNA replication starts. Next. What does it means? Are some specific sequences are there, especially A, T, adenine and thymine sequences are more at that place. Easy, only two hydrogen bonds which can be broken down. With this, the coiled structure of DNA, which is having coils, this coiled structure, by the breakdown of hydrogen bonds with the help of an enzyme called helicase, it will separate. So before we are going to see that RE site, what is RE site? RE site means some sequences which are responsible for starting the replication. Without this, there is no chance of replication at all. RE site means the sequences of nucleotides where replication starts. If RE site is not there, there is no chance of replication. How can you say that there is a chance of replication with RE and no chance? And because of this, the capacity of the DNA molecule to replicate into many copies. For example, we are having mobile nowadays. These mobiles, based upon the cost, based upon the futures we require, based upon our taste, interest, what we want, 2 GB, 4 GB, 8 GB, 30 GB, 64 GB. So based upon its cost and our what we want, our need, our requirement, we are going to purchase. The capacity of the mobile to store information for 2 GB or 10 GB, 30 GB, 40 GB. In the same way, RE site means a place in the DNA which is capable of producing more DNA molecules. So one DNA will become 2 DNA, 2 will become 4. Like this, the capacity of DNA to multiply itself into many number of copies. So based upon the RE site, the number of copies may be more or less. If you are going to do rDNA technology, recombinant technology or biotechnology in the method of gene cloning, suppose I want to clone some genes of some organism which is good for me, I will take that gene. Gene is nothing but DNA. So here, whatever I have collected the gene, this gene is called desirable gene, or this is called a foreign DNA. What is meant by foreign DNA? I have collected this from some other human being who is red in color. Red color is nothing but a character. Red color is a character that is controlled and presented, formed, and it will be supplied to other its generations is by some gene. Gene is nothing but literally to say DNA molecule having some sequences. So with my knowledge, I have traced that organism who is red in color, that man. I search for his DNA. In the DNA, I have identified this is the gene. This is responsible for the red color in that organism, that human being, red color. I want that gene. I want that gene, many copies. So when I want that gene, I have isolated that DNA, I have removed that gene, I have cut it and separated it here. I want this gene to be cloned. Cloned means same type of genes. I want hundreds, thousands. What to do? If we want to clone this desirable gene or foreign DNA or gene of interest, what I will do? I have to get it in more number of copies. How? I will prepare one vector. Vector is nothing but, you will see this in biotechnology classes. Vector is nothing but a plasmid. A plasmid, a small DNA molecule which is found in some bacterial cells, or we can construct. All are nothing but two strands having DNA only, circular DNA. It is called vector. Vector means carrier. What carries? It is having some RE site. Compulsorily we have to create. RE site means the site where replication starts. Now I want this gene to be cloned. I want 100, 200, 300 copies. The number of copies control is in RE site capacity of the mobile. What I just now explained. A mobile is having 2 GB capacity or 10 GB. Both the punish capacity, its features are different. Here also, RE site is that which is capable to produce more number of copies based upon our interest. Now I am going to join this with this vector. For example, this is having this color, green in color, red in color. I have joined here. What is this gene of my interest? Red colored gene. And I will keep this in a bacterial cell. Here, in this bacterial cell, which is having RE site and our gene of interest, desirable gene. Now, this bacterial cell is allowed to grow in the medium, biotechnology, the culture medium. Hundreds, thousands of bacterial cells are growing. Along with the bacterial cells, our gene of interest also growing. This process is called cloning process. Production of multiple copies of desirable gene. This is called vector. Vector is nothing but a plasmid. And without RE site, this is not able to replicate. So RE site or origin of replication is that place in the DNA which is responsible for replicating multiple copies. So whenever a gene of interest from taken from some other source, if we want to
get more number of copies, it cannot produce itself unless it is incorporated into a vector. A vector should have RE site. So whenever we are joining these with a vector having RE site, it is able to replicate. So replication process without origin of replication or RE site is not possible. So RE site is responsible for the replication process and the number of copies. So for example, I want this some 1000 copies. We will select a RE site having capability of producing 1000 copies per cell. Per cell means bacterial cell. So in a bacterial cell, when we are going to incorporate, in the bacterial cell it is going to replicate, and the bacteria also going to divide. In the bacterial cell also it is replicating, and when our bacteria is dividing, in that also it is replicating. So we are going to get 1000 copies per cell. This is the capacity. If I take another RE site which is more, I want 10,000 capability of RE site. So in the market of biotechnology, genetic engineering, gene cloning means same gene is cloned here, thousands of copies, and it is nothing but biotechnology. Biotechnology is that the latest technology of present day in the modern genetics, modern molecular biology, where we are going to join various genes, different plant genes, we can, or plant genes into animals, animal genes into plant. So unless there is some bio patent, or unless there is some law or condition, anything can be, would be manipulated. So in the coming classes we are going to see this. We have just seen what is replication. After that, the mechanism of replication having enzymes various. Again, we have started, replication starts at a place called origin of replication, which is called RE site. What is RE site? We have discussed. And RE site in prokaryotes, only one RE site is there. In eukaryotes, various RE sites are there. For today's class, next class we are going to continue the steps of replication along with this, including. అసలు వచ్చి ఉండదు సురేష్ సార్.